Hey guys, so I have this wooden chest that I bought in a garage sale. I painted it all white and I want to do a cloud pour on top of it. So I'm going to remove the top, unscrew those little screws, and set myself up, and I'm going for this. Alright you guys, so I just want to show you what I'm using, okay? I have my cloud mix here, which is about at least minimum two months old. I have for my base, I'm going to be using the Artist Loft Flow Acrylic, and I got my Liquitex Basics. As I've mentioned before, I find that that's the best paint for the cloud pour. I emptied all that in there, and I want a dark gray color to match with my living room, and I only have a light gray in the Liquitex Basics. So what I'm going to do is I have this older black here. I'm just going to put a bit in. And mix that up. Before adding the pouring medium and the water. I'm going to create my color first. First drop of paint on my new table. I'm in my new art room. And I'm not done setting it all up yet, so that's why I haven't given the grand tour. But I did buy a table, a low table, which I love. Now I have way too much paint in there. I'm gonna have to maybe transfer some to be able to add water and everything. But just to give you an idea, that's how I'm rolling today. I'm going to have the white base and my cloud pour, which is going to be yellow, dark gray, and white to match my my living room. All right, so here we go. Now I'm wearing a glove on my... Clearly I have no choice. This is my stupid cast. And I'm left-handed now. I've been doing a lot of things with my left hand for the past 2 weeks, and it doesn't hurt anymore, by the way, you guys. What happened is that I fractured this bone here, like, in a good place. So it's not that bad, and it doesn't hurt anymore. It's just annoying to have the cast on. And I couldn't wait to pour. Okay, so here we go. Gosh, I haven't done this in so long. Now, I know it's looking super rough. Not giving a crap today, you guys. Seriously, this is not something fancy. This is a super old piece of wood, and it's going to be a corner decoration for something I won't be using very much. I'm going to store like souvenirs and like stuff that I don't take out very often in there. So my yellow is going in first. I did add some water into this. It's 2 or 3 months old and it has thickened up a bit. A little bit of the cloud. Yellow. Darkish gray color. Cloud mix again. And then that's enough. And I'm gonna put in the grayish color. And I'm just gonna go with that for now. I'm gonna make a few, like everywhere, sort of. Okay, so that one has a lot of gray in the background. This one's gonna have, I definitely want the white, the yellow. I think what I'm gonna do this time is I'm gonna put a little bit of the gray. Yellow. Cloud, yellow, gray, and then I'm gonna go here. How about I pour with my left hand? Why not? I'm left-handed now. That's so funny. Oh my god. Whew. Not easy. I'm stopping. I'm scared that this won't work. All of a sudden I'm panicking. I think I'm gonna have to prepare some more white to put around it. I don't know. It is reacting a lot though. I'm just gonna I'm gonna put this color here. Why not? There. What's gonna happen? Okay, I'm gonna go down to that corner. And then I'm gonna go down there. At worst, I can fix this with white. I learned that last year, a bit over a year ago. If I don't like it, just put some white and push the paint I don't like off. But up till now, it's not so bad. Ooh, I love how they're all so different. Oh, damn. I think I'm actually liking it. There's just this corner here, and now I'll let it go. It's gonna fit so well in my living room, you guys. I'm really liking it this way.
I was afraid. I got a little moment of panic, but I really, really, really like it. And I love how it's gonna fit perfectly in my living room. Now, I didn't move it around the same way that I normally move around the cloud pour. I usually turn all the way through to stretch it out. And this is the one, actually, this one here looks more like my normal cloud pours. But given the fact that it was super long and that there were four, it was a bit different here. I tried to cover the sides and... Anyways, I really... Seriously, you guys, I'm loving it. And that sort of the dark color that looks almost black. Well, my wall is almost that color. It's a very, very dark gray. More like up here. And as I mentioned in a post a little while ago, I'm just feeling yellow so much these days. By the way, I have to say, I'm loving my light in my new art room because this looks exactly like I see it on camera in reality. So stay tuned for the dried result, and I'm going to be putting it back where it goes to show you guys the overall look in my living room. Back with the dried result. It did take a while to dry, like almost 2 days, but I'm really happy with the colors. They came out really well, and check it out. Got some fractals. Awesome paint reaction there. So let me go and set this up. Loving it. The gray here is the same as the gray on my wall. The overall look is pretty sick. Hope you guys like this. Have a good one.